नमस्ते एवरीवन, दिस इज संदीप एंड वेलकम टू माय चैनल ओनली स्टडी बाय संदीप धीमान। वी वर डिस्कसिंग लेसन नंबर 6, लाइफ ऑन द अर्थ। वी हैड डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द इकोसिस्टम, फ्लोरा फौना, एंड वी हैड स्टार्टेड डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द प्लांट किंगडम। एंड इन प्लांट किंगडम वी हैड डिस्कस्ड दैट देयर आर 4 टाइप्स ऑफ वेजिटेशंस, एंड वी हैड डिस्कस्ड अबाउट ट्रॉपिकल हार्डवुड फॉरेस्ट। In tropical hardwood forest, we had discussed that there are 2 types of tropical hardwood forest. Today we'll discuss grasslands. Now, what are grasslands? The areas where vegetation is dominated by the grass or grass-like plants, that is called grasslands. Okay. And in grasslands, there is scanty rainfall. Okay. And temperature conditions vary place to place, and on the basis of climatic conditions we can divide them into 2 groups. Okay, the first one is tropical grasslands. Tropical grasslands, they are located between equatorial forests, okay, and hot deserts also in both the hemispheres, and they receive 100 centimeter, about 100 centimeter rainfall, okay, more than 75 and about 100 centimeter, and they have rough, thick and tall grasses. Okay, these grasslands have rough, thick and tall grasses. Campos in Brazil are typical example of these forests. Clear? Okay, so in this we discussed that there are 2 types of grasslands on the basis of climatic conditions. The first one we discussed, tropical grasslands, they are found between equatorial forests and hot deserts in both hemispheres. They receive about 100 centimeter rainfall and they have rough, thick and tall grasses. And Campos in Brazil is an example of tropical grasslands. Now here we have temperate grasslands. So in our 6th class we had discussed about the temperate zone. So it is located there. Okay, in the temperate zone we find temperate grasslands, and in the interior parts of the continents also they receive 25 to 75 centimeter rainfall and sometimes snowfall also. These grasslands have short and soft grasses, and their names are different in different areas. For example, prairies in North America, pampas in South America, downs in Australia, wild in South America. Now, there is always a confusion which grassland in which area. So let me tell you, North America, America, here it is found in America and Canada. Clear? You can see here in the map. Here is pampas. Pampas is in North America, and this is mainly Argentina. Okay, and it is wild. It is found in Africa. And this country is South Africa. Clear? This is Australia, and it is found in downs, is found in Australia, and here it is pustas and steppes. So you can see here steppes, Europe and Asia, in both continents it is found. Now look here, let me tell you some trick. America is a rich country, and if you want to go to America you need to pay. So pray and pay, prairies, pay rupees. In this way you can memorize this. Pampas, where is pampas? North America, Argentina. Suppose a girl is there named Tina, and she got an heart attack. So somebody say pump Tina, because she got an heart attack. Clear? I hope you got it. Next, here, South Africa. So you know South Africa, Sean Pollock, and fast bowlers are there. And here the pitches are very fast, and if you play here you get bowled. Okay, when you play here you get bowled. So bailed, bowled, you can remember this. And steppy is Europe and Asia. It is called Eurasia. Okay, it is called Eurasia. So steppies, tape like sound, taping. So taping is done in Europe and Asia, so it is called Eurasia. Clear? Now here downs in Australia. You know Australia, the pitches of Australia are very fast, and there is big bounce in those pitches. Okay, so bounce, downs, you can relate this with this. I hope you got all these points. So in this we discussed that temperate grasslands are located in temperate and temperate zone and in interior parts of the continents, and they receive 25 to 75 centimeter rainfall and sometimes snowfall also, and they have short and soft grasses, and these are different names of the grasslands. Let's move to the next one. Now here we have deserts. So what is a desert? Desert where is less vegetation. The areas having less vegetation due to very scanty rainfall is known as a desert. And on the basis of temperature we can divide them into two groups, hot and cold. So hot deserts, there is a high temperature throughout the year. And some important deserts are here: Sahara Desert, it is in Africa; Thar in India; Atacama in South America. And the common vegetation is cactus, shrubs, bushes. You know it very well. Okay, so these are hot deserts. Then after, we have cold deserts. So where it's snow. Okay, especially polar regions, they are found in polar regions, and temperature is here below freezing point throughout the year. And the common vegetation comprised mosses, lichens, etc. And Siberia in Russia and north part of Canada have these deserts. Clear? I hope up to here everything you have got. Now we have temperate softwood forest. Where are they found? They are found in continental interior of high altitude as well as high altitudes of Asia, Europe, North America, South America, New Zealand. Okay, so in these areas they are found, and the vegetation is known as taiga. These are also known as coniferous forest because they have cone-bearing trees. Cone-bearing trees means pine family trees. These trees also have conical shapes and have very soft wood, and they have needle-shaped leaves, and they are more uniform and consist of pure stand of few species. The main trees are pine, fir, spruce, lark, etc. Larch. Next we have the animal kingdom. If we talk about the animal kingdom, we had discussed that in biosphere with the plants there live animals, and because in equatorial regions there is heavy rainfall and heavy temperature, high temperature, so they are found tall and thick trees. This provide thick vegetation cover, and it makes possible to have large variety of animals. So the common animals here are different types of monkeys, elephants, crocodiles, insect eating animals like armadillos, snakes, etc. And in the grasslands, the number of animals is less as compared to equatorial forest, because less vegetation is there. And in grasslands, common animals are lion, cheetah, leopard, deer, and rabbits. Okay, such types of animals live here. If we talk about the polar region, then there live the animals having thick fur to protect their body from extreme cold. And the most common animals found there: penguin, polar bear, etc. Next we have, what is the impact of humans on the ecosystem? So we know, due to rapid increase in population, the forest area is decreasing very fast. Forests are cleared for the expansion of habitats, and ecological balance is highly disturbed all over the world. Temperature is decreasing, and some species like tigers, lions, they are in danger. They are facing the danger of extinction, and pollution level that is rising alarmingly, and there is a rise in global temperature. Some glaciers are melting. Now this is the time for the man to realize his mistake and stop tampering with the nature. And for maintaining ecological balance, afforestation should be taken up on a large scale, and the hunting of animals should be strictly banned. And for the preservation of different animal species, the government has set up wildlife sanctuaries, national parks, and biosphere reserves. And these are a few measures to maintain ecological balance of animals. Many non-governmental bodies or organizations have come forward to help in protecting different types of animal species. So this is Nanda Devi Bioreserve, and this is tiger roaming freely in Kanha National Park. So this is your homework. Tell me, where is Nanda Devi Bioreserve and where is Kanha National Park? Comment it in the comment box. And one more important thing, what is conservation? The wise use, conservation is related to wise use, and preservation, not to use. Okay, and these are for the protection of the animals and their habitats. Okay, so this is all for the day. Thank you.